brief you what the program is really about. Given the fact that a lot of Muslims are being oppressed around the world, and the amount of enmity that's portrayed towards Muslims, we thought it's, you know, rather important that all of us get together and pray for them. However, the criteria for meeting here, for gathering here today, is not only Muslims. It's for all the people that are oppressed around the world. We all have to remember one thing: no matter how young we are, no matter how old we are, no matter if we are boys or we are girls, if we are male or we are female, okay, if we are Muslims or we are non-Muslims, when we came into the earth, we were first human beings. And this is the most important thing today, that we have all gathered here to pray for all those people around the world who are oppressed in any other way, be it in the Middle Eastern countries or in Europe, wherever. This program has been organized by Bilal Muslim Mission of Tanzania in collaboration with Sikh Perfection, which is a group of youths who have come together and opened a website to create positivity towards Islam. Just a brief introduction towards the program. We will start with the recitation of the Quran. We'll have a short recitation for 5 minutes, followed by a talk by Sheikh Murtaza Alidina. After that, we'll proceed towards Dua Joshan and Sagir. From thereafter, we will be having a talk by Sheikh Jalala for 5 to 10 minutes, and then we'll proceed to Dua number 27 from Saif Sajadia. Thereafter, if you have noticed, we have a white banner placed right outside the mosque for the gents and for the ladies. Right beneath the banner, we have placed marker pens. It is our sincere request to all of us here to take the marker pen and write on the banner a message towards those who are oppressed, a message to the people around the world that we are together with them. We are in safer lands, we are in better circumstances than them, but remember one thing: our blood, our hearts, our minds are still with them. So before we all go back home, before we start having our niyaz, or even after our niyaz, can you please just take the red marker, write a message, be it from you, be it from your family, be it from anyone. Today you're not representing yourself, you're not representing your family only, but you're representing humanity. So once again, brothers and sisters, please, it is again our sincere request, please, please do make sure that you do sign that particular banner. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءَ 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 أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءَ. الفاتحة. The chief guest, His Excellency the Ambassador of the Islamic Republic of Iran, respected scholars, Sheikh Dr. Murtaza Alidina, my elders of the community, my brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I wish to take this opportunity to thank you all for gracing this event, a special occasion, on a special day, for special people in a special world that we all live in. Today's program, as stated before, is meant to be done because of the prayers for the people around the world, particularly the people who are oppressed. Salawat ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. My fellow community members, we have just been graced with the presence of Sheikh Hamid Jalala. Can you all please welcome with the salawat ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Without taking much of your time today, I will request Brother Saif Musa to come forward and recite a few verses from the Holy Quran.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والسماء ذات البروج اليوم المعود وشاهد ومشهود قتل أصحاب الأخدود النار ذات الوقود إذ هم عليها قعود وهم على ما يفعلون بالمؤمنين شهود وما نقموا منهم إلا أن يؤمنوا بالله العزيز الحميد الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض والله على كل شيء شهيد إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات ثم لم يتوبوا فلهم عذاب جهنم ولهم عذاب الحريق إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار ذلك الفوز الكبير إن بطش ربك لشديد إنه هو يبدئ ويعيد وهو الغفور الودود ذو العرش المجيد فعال لما يريد هل أتاك حديث الجنود فرعون وثمود بل الذين كفروا في تكذيب والله من ورائهم محيط بل هو قرآن مجيد في لوح محفوظ صلاة
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد.
Thank you very much, Brother Saif. Brothers and sisters, I'll now request Sheikh Dr. Murtadha Ali Dina to come forward and give us a few words. Sheikh Tafadhal.
بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وآله الطاهرين. Respected scholars, the chief guest, elders, brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. We have assembled here tonight to remember our brothers and sisters who are being oppressed throughout the world. The Quran teaches us that it is our duty to relate to others, to remember others and their pain and their suffering, and to sympathize for them and to do all that is necessary to help them and remove that pain and cause of suffering from them. In the riwayah, we are told that al-mu'minu akhul mu'min, the believing brother is to his other mu'min a brother by faith, even if he is not a brother by blood or a brother by relation of marriage. And therefore, the brotherhood shows sympathy and concern for each other. Al-mu'minu akhul mu'min kal jasadil واحد, it's as if they are parts of the same body. إن اشتكى شيئا منه وجد ألم ذلك في سائر جسده. If one part of the body experiences pain or damage or suffering, the rest of the body also experiences pain. The body cannot sleep if one part of the body is in pain. If we recognize that we are members of the same body, the Ummah, and therefore if today some part of the body of the Ummah is suffering, then if we are connected through the same body, then the rest of the body cannot sleep. If there's somebody hungry there, if somebody is being deprived of his rights, if somebody is being oppressed, if somebody's life is under threat, indeed, if somebody is under the threat of attack, then we should also feel sympathy if we are part of the same ummah. In fact, the Quran condemns, مَا لَكُمْ. What is the problem with you if you're a true believer? If somebody else is being oppressed, you take no action to help them. And the Quran says, therefore, whoever is concerned, وَمَنْ أَحْيَاهَا فَكَأَنَّمَا أَحْيَا النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا. You show concern for the others who are suffering. It's as if you have shown concern for the whole of humanity. If we do not care for somebody else, the Quran says we're not human. Forget about being a mu'min. You take away somebody's life, you have taken away the life of the whole of humanity. You protect one life, you have protected humanity. Kwanini? Kwa sababu, if you can respect one life, you'll respect all lives. If you lose your care and concern for one human life, you won't care for any other human life. So the Quran goes one step ahead. Not only are we believers and part of the same body of the Ummah, our humanity requires us to be concerned. So in Surah Hujurat, Allah says that إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. The believers truly are brothers. فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ. And therefore you should reconcile between two brothers if there is any dispute. Brother and sister, parents and children, husband and wife, two warring families, employer and employee. No, two warring nations. أَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ. It is your duty to make all the necessary efforts to stop this war that is happening between two individuals or two groups of individuals. And once all the necessary effort has been made, but then an oppressor and an aggressor is identified, and an oppressed and a victim of aggression is identified, then you take all the necessary steps to stop the aggressor and the oppressor to hurt the victim. And one of those steps definitely would be all the necessary protest, all the necessary efforts to shape the decision of stopping the war. And one of the most powerful weapons that we have is dua. And one of the things we're going to do tonight is dua. الدُّعَاءُ سِلَاحُ الْمُؤْمِنِ. One of the most powerful weapons a mu'min has is dua. It is the shield of a mu'min to protect himself from danger, from himself and from others. We notice that the messengers in the Quran have been mentioned that when they were in trouble, they would also make dua. So for example, Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, as mentioned in Surah Mu'minun or Surah Shu'ara or Surah Qamar, he makes a dua. He tries to fight against evil, but when he is overwhelmed, he prays to God, Rabbi, Anni maghloob fantasir. Oh Allah, I've done all my best to stop the evil, but they're not listening. I'm now outnumbered. I am overwhelmed. I have lost all my capacity to be able to oppose and to stop the evil. فَانْتَصِرْ. Oh Allah, now you avenge, you protect the truth, you protect the good people, the innocent. The same dua is made, for example, by Prophet Lut alayhi salam in Surah Ankabut, ayah number 30, after all his admonition and efforts to stop evil. Finally, he says, Rabbi, unsurni ala al-qawmi al-mufsideen. Oh Allah, I've done my best to stop the evil, but they're not ready to listen. Oh Allah, you now give me triumph and protection and victory against this corruptive, wicked, deliberately, defiantly evil-doing people who are abusing their power. Or in the case of Prophet Shu'aib in Surah A'raf, Allah quotes Shu'aib alayhi salam to say, عَلَى اللَّهِ تَوَكَّلْنَا رَبَّنَا افْتَحْ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَ قَوْمِنَا بِالْحَقِّ وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الْفَاتِحِينَ. Oh Allah, I've tried my best to stop this economic crimes of this community, but they're not ready to listen. And therefore I pray to you that you grant us victory. You make a judgment of who's right and who's wrong between the two of us, and you grant us victory. Indeed, you are the best of those who help the oppressed. So to make a dua is a sunnah of the prophets. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi made dua in the Battle of Badr. Allahumma alayka bi Quraysh, Sahih Muslim, Sahih Bukhari, Muslim ibn Hanbal. All the history books quote the Prophet's prayer. Allahumma alayka bi Quraysh, Allahumma alayka bi Quraysh. Three times he makes this dua. To make a dua against the evil forces, once they've been identified and all efforts have failed to stop them, is a sunnah not only of the past messengers, is a sunnah of the last Prophet. Allah, no! The Prophet goes one step ahead. Allahumma alayka bi Abi Jahal Fir'aun hadhihi al-umma. Abi Jahal bin Hisham. Allahumma alayka bi Uqaba bin Abi Mu'ayt. Allahumma alayka bi Ubay bin Khalaf. Allahumma alayka bi Utaba bin Rabi'a. Allahumma alayka bi Shayba bin Rabi'a. Allahumma alayka bil Walid bin Utba. When evil has been identified, who is the head of evil? Who is the ruling class of evil? And who is supporting the aggressors and the oppressors? And Allah has blessed them with power, with influence, with military weapons, but they are abusing it now against the innocent. It is our duty to pray, to stop evil. Once we cannot stop evil, definitely we must pray. Even if we don't pray, there are angels who are praying. Tabbat yada Abi Lahab wa tab. May Abu Lahab perish, and may he be wasted, and may he be lost. No, he has two hands. Two hands meaning what? All his energy, all his power, may they be destroyed. Watab, and he, Abu Lahab himself, should be destroyed. Whose prayer is this? Not the messengers. It's God praying. This surah that was recited by the brother here, Surah Al-Buruj. Qutila ashabul ukhdud. Let the people of the ditch be destroyed. They what did they do? An-nari dhatil waqud, the ditch which was filled with fire. Idhum alayha qu'ud, bahum ala ma yaf'aluna bil mu'minin shuhud. They are sitting, they are watching, they've lit this fire, they've identified who is a believer. They oppose him, they persecute him, they arrest him, and they put him in the fire. In the past, it was the fire lit by wood. Now we have chemical fires, we have chemical burning taking place. A fire, cause of suffering. So you think if you and me, we don't pray, the angels are not praying, the messengers are not praying. Allah has not created a system which is not praying against the zalim. No. Our question is, are we believers that there is a God? And this God, based on wisdom, gives power to some. And then Allah tests them with that power. And then Allah wants to see those who are being victimized and oppressed, what do they do against this abuse of power? And whether they pass the test of rising up against evil or they sit quiet. You sit quiet, this generation goes away, another generation will come who will fight against oppression to stop oppression. Therefore, alhamdulillah, we have chosen a good occasion, the eve of Friday. The riwayah says from the time of Maghrib till the time of Fajr, the angels come down and say, who is there amongst you who is a sinner? Let him ask for forgiveness. Who is there who is in need? Let him pray for his needs to be fulfilled. Who is sick? so that his sickness can be removed. O Allah, we have come to you on this occasion when we are concerned about the oppressed, and we are praying to you when your doors of mercy and grace are open. The one important thing that we need to keep in mind when we make a dua is that our dua should be sincere, it should be earnest, it should be honest from the bottom of our heart. This dua of Amman Yujib is a very powerful dua. Amman Yujibul Muzhtarra Iza Da'ahu Wa Yakshifu Su. Who is there who will pray to God as a muzhtar? Muzhtar, one who is in the state of darura, one who is in total need, who experiences his desperation. Nobody else can help. My own efforts and energy cannot help me. Others around cannot help me. Oh Allah, I've turned to you in a state of total need and total powerlessness and helplessness. Muzhtar. Iza da'a. And then I make a sincere, honest, earnest plea, beseeching, request. Iza da'a. Who? And I pray to you and you alone. Who else is there other than you? This dua has one condition. The riwayah says when you make a dua, if you are a zalim and you are praying against the zalim, O Allah, curse the zalim, disarm the zalim, paralyze the zalim, punish the zalim. Who is the zalim? Excuse me. If I do zulm on myself, I drink alcohol, God forbid, which is haram. This is zulm on myself. I'm praying against myself. If I do zulm to my parents, to my relatives, to my friends, to my spouse, to my children, I'm praying against myself. If I make zulm on others in society, the dua says, if there is a munkar, an act of zulm, and you do not do nahi anil munkar, everything possible to stop that munkar, then whenever you will pray, your prayers will not be accepted. Kwa nini? Kwa sababu you are praying against zulm and you yourself are zalim. So one very important condition for our dua to be accepted. Yes, we have chosen the right place, the masjid. Yes, we have chosen the right time, the eve of Friday. Yes, we are assembled and collected, sincere believers. Yes, we shall pray from the bottom of our hearts. But we should also ask for forgiveness if ourselves we are doing dhul. Is it on ourselves, or is it on others, or is it on society? And therefore, this dua that we shall make, for example, dua Jawshan Saghir. It's a powerful dua. Jawshan means protection. Imam Musa bin Ja'far al-Kadhim. Got the news that the Abbasi Khalifa, Musa bin Mahdi al-Abbasi, was planning to assassinate him. So his family and friends of Imam alayhi salam got worried. Imam said, no, he will not be able to harm me. And they were surprised, how so? He's such a powerful Khalifa. And the answer was, no, I saw the Prophet in a vision. And the Prophet informed me that you make this dua and Allah will protect you. And before the evil emperor can do anything to harm you, harm will reach that emperor himself. Before he can make you die, Allah will make him die. This dua is that powerful. Jawshan Saghir. Basically in this dua, we say, Imam alayhi salam says, oh Allah, I've got an enemy out there. I don't know him, I can't see him, but he's there. And he's planning and he's plotting and he's got his dagger and his sword ready and he's sharpening it and he's got his arrow and he's got his poison and he's watching and monitoring me and he's plotting and oh Allah, you know my weakness, that he can ambush me, but then I know from my past experience, whenever I'm in trouble, I turn to you, you never abandon me. Oh Allah, I've come to you. And then Imam says, yes, but there could be others who are inimical to me. who are spying on me. There are those who are envious and jealous of me, who attack me by their tongues, by their eyes. O Allah, how many times you have saved me from trouble. O Allah, your grace is endless. O Allah, I sometimes groan and moan in pain, and you relieve and rescue me from that illness. Sometimes I'm terrified and horrified by a dreadful event, and you help me. Sometimes there are people in prison and you rescue them. Sometimes people are attacked in the wilderness, sometimes in the seas with huge killer waves. Sometimes they are attacked by ferocious animals and you protect them. Sometimes the people lost in the desert. Sometimes people are overwhelmed with illnesses. Sometimes they're prisoners of war. And Allah, Imam Alayhi Salaam keeps on listing different situations, all possible situations in whereby the human being becomes overwhelmed with forces beyond his control. And then he turns to God, and the God who is the all-powerful one, who gives life moment by moment, who knows who the enemy is, who gives the power to the enemy to be able to plan, and he's testing the enemy. Lakini, the ability of the enemy to take the sword and to lift it up and to bring it down with force, and for the sword to work and cut, and for the skin to be soft enough to be cut, and for the sword to enter the body and hurt and damage and sever those sensitive parts of the body which are necessary for my life. All of it, O Allah, moment by moment is under your control. Where else do I go to, O God? And if I've come to you, no, we have come to you, no, we are praying to you on a holy night, in a holy place, for our brothers and sisters who are oppressed. O Allah, help us become one strong humanity of good people against evil. Sadaqallahu al-Azim.
Thank you very much, Sheikh Dr. Lidina. We're now moving to the next agenda on the program, which is Dua Josh and Sagir. This dua has been emphasized a lot by Sheikh already. Our sincere request to all of us here is to please remember everyone in your prayers. As Sheikh said, also ask for forgiveness of our sins. Gentlemen and ladies, I'll now request Sheikh Musa to come forward, Sheikh Hamis Musa to come forward and recite Dua Josh and Sagir. Can you all please welcome him with a loud salawat ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
ولي شباح الدين وداف لي قواتل سمومي وسدد إلي صوائب سهمي ولم تنم عني عين حراستي وأضمر أن يسومني المكروه ويجرعني زعاف مرارتي فنظرت إلى ضعفي عن احتمال الفوادع وعجزي عن الانتصار ممن قصدني بمحاربتي ووحدتي في كثير ممن ناوأني وأرصد لي فيما لم أعمل فكري في الإرصاد لهم بمثلي فأيدتني بقدرتك وشددت أزري بنصرتك وفللت لي جده حده وخذلته بعد جميع عديده وحشده وعليت كعبي علي ووجهت ما سدد إلي من مكائده إلي ورددته علي ولم يشفي غليله ولم تبرر خزازات عيضي وقد عض على أناملي وأدمرا موليان قد أخفقت سرايا فلك الحمد يا ربي من مقتدر لا يغلب وذي أناة لا يعجل صل على محمد وآل محمد واجعلني لنعمائك من الشاكرين ولآلائك من الذاكرين إلهي وكان من باغ بغاني بمكائدي ونصب لي أشراك مصائدي ووكل بي تفقد رعايتي وأضبى إلي إضباء السبع لطريدتي انتظارا لانتهازي فرصتي وهو يظهر بشاشة المالق ويبسط وجها غير طالق فلما رأيت دغل سريرتي وقبح من طوى عليه لشريكي في ملتي وأصبح مجلبا لي في بغي والرماح وآلة الحار يتقعقع في الحديد قد بلغ مجهودا لا يعرف حيلة ولا يجد مهربا قد أدنف بالحرارة بالحراحة أو متشحطا بدمي تحت السنابك والأرجل يتمنى شربا من الماء أو نظرة إلى أهله وولده لا يقدر عليها وأنا في عافية من ذلك كله فلك الحمد يا ربي من مقتدر لا يغلب وذي أناة لا يعجل وفي لباسها يتقلب يمينا وشمالا لا يعرف شيئا من لذة الطعام ولا من لذة الشراب ينظر إلى نفسه حسرة لا يستطيع لها ضرا ولا نفعا وأنا خلو من ذلك كله بجودك وكرمك فلا إله إلا أنت سبحانك من مقتدر لا يغلب وذي أناة لا يعجل صل على محمد وآل محمد واجعلني لك من العابدين ولنعمائك من الشاكرين ولآلائك من الذاكرين وارحمني برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين فلا إله إلا أنت سبحانك من مقتدر لا يغلب وذي أناة لا يعجل صل على محمد وآل محمد واجعلني لنعمائك من الشاكرين ولآلائك من الذاكرين وارحمني برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد سجد وجهي الذليل لوجهك العزيز الجليل سجد وجهي البالي الفاني لوجهك الدائم الباقي سجد وجهي الفقير لوجهك الغني الكبير سجد وجهي وسمعي وبصري ولحمي ودمي وجلدي وعظمي وما أقلت الأرض مني لله رب العالمين اللهم عد على جهلي بحلمك وعلى فقري بغناك وعلى ذلي بعزك وسلطانك وعلى ضعفي بقوتك وعلى خوفي بأمنك وعلى ذنوبي وخطاياي بعفوك ورحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم إني أدرأ بك في نحر عدوي وأعوذ بك من شره فاكفني بما كفيت به أنبياءك وأولياءك من خلقك وصالح عبادك من فراعنة خلقك وطغاة عداتك وشر جميع خلقك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين إنك على كل شيء قدير وحسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد
The fathers losing their mothers, the fathers losing their kids right in front of their eyes. Oh my Lord, today I stand here asking for forgiveness for you for not being able to thank you for all the wonderful mercies you have brought on me. My Lord, I also sit here and stand here right in front of everyone to thank you for gracing us with the opportunity to gather all of us here to be able to pray for the people oppressed around the world. Brothers and sisters, before we go for Dua Ahlul Thagur, I request Sheikh Hilmi Jalala to come forward and give us a few words. Sheikh, tafadhal. Salawat ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ثم الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله خير خلق الله البشير النذير والسراج المنير الطهر الطاهر العلم الظاهر المنصور المؤيد المصطفى الأمجد حبيب إله العالمين أبي القاسم محمد أيها السادة والعلماء والحضور الكرام أحييكم بتحية الإسلام المباركة السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته إسلام محمد بن عبد الله مبني على خطين الخط الأول هو الخط الشعوري والخط الثاني هو الخط الواعي الفكري الإدراكي وإسلام أليكو جناهم ثم صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم Uislamu huo umejengwa katika khati mbili, katika system mbili. Khati ya kwanza, namna ya kwanza ni namna ya hisia. Namna ya hisia, namna ya huruma. Hii ni khati ya kwanza. Khati ya pili ni al-khatu al-fikri. الواعي الإدراكي الفهمي ni system ya kufahamu kutumia akili kutambua kuelewa hizi ndiyo khati za dini alizokuja nazo au dini aliyokuja nayo Mtume Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Ma yajri fi Suriya al-an, ma yajri fi tilka al-bilad at-tayyiba, huwa ma yata'allaqu bihadhaini al-khattaini. Yanayotokea katika ardhi ya Syria leo hii, yanayotokea mashariki ya kati, yana mafungamano kwa asilimia 100 kwa hizi khati mbili. Khati ya fikra, al-khatu al-wa'i, al-shu'uri, na khati ambayo, wal-khatu al-ladhi, la shu'ura lahu, wala fikrata lahu, wala aqla lahu, wala fahma la. Khati ya pili, iliyoko pale Syria, iliyoko pale mashariki ya kati, inayofanya haya yote yanayotokea leo, ni system hii ambayo si ya mtume. System ambayo haina hisia, haina huruma. Kitu cha kwanza, awwalu ma nazala min al-Qur'an al-Karim kanat suratu Iqra am ayatu Iqra, walakin qabla nuzuli Iqra kanat hunaka muqaddima wa hiya bismillahir rahmanir rahim Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. Kwa hivyo unapata kwamba hata Qur'ani iliposhuka, aya ya kwanza ilikuwa ni Iqra, lakini Iqra haikushuka mpaka ikaja bismillah. Wa bismillahir rahmanir rahim huwa yahki wa yuwaddih wa yubayyin anil khatt al-awwal. Bismillah inabainisha system ya kwanza, system ya hisia, system ya huruma, system ya mapenzi. Naanza kwa jina la Mwenyezi Mungu Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, mwenye huruma, ndio maana yake. Ndugu zangu, yanayotokea Syria ni hayo mawili. Al-khattu shu'uri huwa al-khatt alladhi indama naqra'u at-tarikh نقدر أن نستنطقها في حركات الرسول صلى الله عليه وآله في الطائف وفي أدعيته المباركة وفي مناجاته وفي دفنه لولده إبراهيم عليه السلام. سيستم يهوما أتيباتك ومتومي يهسيا وكتمتومي يكو طائف أليبو بيقوى ماويني مكافيري. Mtume machozi yakawa yanamtoka, anawaonea huruma watu wa Taif, wataadhibiwa na Mungu kwa sababu ya ujinga wao. Khat ya huruma na hisia mtume ameionyesha kwa mwanawe Ibrahim. Lama dafana Ibrahim baka Rasulu sallallahu alayhi wa alihi, ahadu ashabihi saalahu hatta anta ya Rasulallah, faqal أما العين تدمع والقلب يحزن ولا نقول إلا ما يحبه الله ويرضى. Mtume anamzika mwanawe Ibrahim machozi yanamtoka. Mmoja katika masahaba wake anamuuliza, hata wewe pia unalia? Anamwambia ndio. Macho yanatoa machozi, moyo unahuzunika, lakini hatuongei yale ambayo Mungu hayapendi. Movement yoyote, haraka yoyote ikikosekana, ayatu haraka wa ayu nashat idha fukida ashuuri, khatu shuuri fahadha lkhatu fashi. Movement yoyote, haraka yoyote, khati hii ikikosekana, ujue khati hiyo itakuwa katika hatari na haiwezi kufanikiwa. Amma khatu lwai, انظر إلى الرسول صلى الله عليه وآله وهو في مكة يدعو إلى التواحد، يدعو إلى الوحدة، يدعو إلى المحبة، يدعو إلى التسامح وإلى التحابب وإلى التفاهم. أنقلي خطي يكيكيلي، متومي يكو مكة lakini anawalingania watu kwenye umoja, kuelewana, kupendana, kufahamiana. Ma yajri fil aradi suriya huwa fukdanu hadhaini lkhattaini, yanayotokea katika ardhi ya Syria ni kukosekana mirengo hii miwili, ni kupatikana mrengo wa kisalafia wa kiwahabi almutashaddida, alkhattu alwahabi as-salafi almutashaddid al-irhabu al-fatik alladhi la rahmata lahu, yanayotokea katika ardhi ya Suriyatul Asad ya Syria yanayotokea leo ni mauaji ya kimbari yanayotekelezwa na gurupu la kisalafia la kiwahabi ambalo halina kitu kinaitwa huruma katika hisia zao. Haya ndiyo yanayotokea. Shabun yuktal wa huwa yukabbir wa yakulu Allahu akbar, mush yuktal, yuzbah kama yuzbahu al-kabsh, adhabihu yakulu Allahu akbar wal madhbuhu yakulu Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, ayu Allah hadha alladhi taqsidunahu, hadha alladhi yuqalu lahu ar-rahmanu ar-rahim. Anachinjwa kijana Syria leo hii, kijana anayechinjwa anasema Allahu akbar, mchinjaji anasema Allahu akbar. Ni Mungu mkubwa yupi mnayemsema nyinyi? Akthar min dhalika, yudhbahu ash-shab, yudhbahu al-muslim alladhi yantiqu bish-shahadatayn, yudhbahu walladhi yadhbahuhu yad'i al-islam thumma yukhriju kabidahu wa ya'kula, ayu islamin hadha, la rahmata lahu, la shu'ura lahu, wala fikrata lahu, wala fahma la, hadha alladhi yajri fil aradi suriya. Kijana wa kiislamu anayesema la ilaha illallah anachinjwa, na anayemchinja anatoa ini lake analitafuna, anatoa moyo anautafuna, na anajifakharisha kwa hilo. Hakuna katika Uislamu wa mtume Uislamu namna hiyo. Hadha laysa islamu rasulillah, wal islamu salafi al wahabi huwa al mabni ala hadhi al hala, mabnahu bi hadha al uslub at tashaddud, adamu al fikr, adamu al ma'rifa, al madhhar alladhi la yu'jibu ay aqil. Ndio Uislamu wa kiwahabi ulivyo, madhhar, vile unavyoonekana, appearance, sura ambayo haimpendezei mtu, ta'tilu al-aql, at-taqlid wat-ta'assub ash-shadid li'ulama'ihim wattiba'i fatawahum, fatawa mashayikhim biduni an ya'rifu dalail hadhihi al-fatawa. Ndugu zangu, mkirudi mkiwasoma masalafia ambao kazi yao ni kuua, hawana huruma na mtu, hawana hisia na mtu, wafuatilie uwasome. Wao kazi yao, akli haifanyi kazi, imeachwa kando. Maulama wao wanafuatwa kuwafuata ambako pasi na kutumia akili. Ndugu zangu, haya ndiyo yanayotokea leo Syria. Ma yajri fi Suriya huwa hadha al-khat, khatu salafi al-qattal al-fikri al-mutashaddid. Haya ndiyo yanayotokea katika ardhi ya Syria. Alhamdulillah, jamii nnas sunnatan wa shi'atan wa masihiyatan wa yahudiyatan kulluhum iktashafu bi anna hadha al-khat yajibu muwajahatuha. Alhamdulillah, leo dunia nzima, mashia, masuni, wakristo na mayahudi wasio kuwa mazayuni, wote wanaona kwamba khati ya kiwahabi ya kisalafi ni hatari na lazima iondoke duniani. Wa akhiran, ad'u ila jami'i al-muslimina fil alam sunnatan wa shi'atan ومسيحية إلى التوحد، هذا أولا، وإلى بث الوعي في الشعب من التفاهم والانسجام والمحبة فيما بينهم. مشو نوسمشا والمين وكيو مسوني نوكيو مشيا وكيو وكريستو نوكيو wasiokuwa kuwa makristo katika dini nyingine, kwamba waungane, wawe kitu kimoja, waishambulie fikra ya kisalafia na ya kiwahabi, fikra iliyojengwa kwenye kuua na kusambaratisha na kupoteza watu. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka antasamiu alalim, tuba alayna ya maulana innaka antatawabur rahim, waghfir lana warhamna إنك أنت أرحم الراحمين. صلى الله على محمد وآله الطاهرين، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
Thank you very much, Sheikh Jalala. We are finally coming to the end of the program. However, the chief guest, His Excellency, the Ambassador of the Islamic Republic of Iran, would want to address the general public. So I'll request him to come forward. Before that, can we please recite Allahu salawat ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wa bihi nasta'in. Innahu khayrun nasirin wa mu'in. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Innal ladhina qalu rabbuna Allah thumma istaqamu تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون. صدق الله العلي العظيم. Dear guests, dear brother and brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. First of all, I thank God for giving us this opportunity to gather here to pray for the oppressed and resistance people, our brothers and sisters in Syria, Lebanon, Iraq, Bahrain, Egypt, Afghanistan, Pakistan, Iran, and all over the world. The Islamic Revolution in Iran, during its past 35 years, has had many great and invaluable achievements and caused plenty of blessings and graces for the Islamic Ummah. Reviving Islam and its role and capacity and position in international arena has been one of the most important achievements and divine graces. Another grace of Islamic revolution in the region, in Middle East especially, is reviving the culture and symbol of resisting against tyrants and oppressors, in which bravely resistance of Muslim nation of Lebanon against the Zionist occupiers is the obvious pattern of it. This resistance has succeeded with empty hands by faith and trust in God could make great and honorable and historic victories against the full-armed Zionist, who is supported unlimited from global upper source. These victories has nullified all enemies' plans for Middle East and completely changed their conditions and their calculations, so that in recent years we were witnessing the kneel down of enemies and disorder their calculations. The resistance victory of Lebanon in 33 days war in July 2006 was so similar to divine miracle. The whole infidels and enemies in the region and out of region were united to defeat Hezbollah. But resistance by trust in God and faith power overcome on enemies and cause the honor for all global freedom lovers. But the enemy didn't stop its efforts. In this victory, only Iran and Syria have supported their resistance. Ashkurukum lahudur.
Thank you very much, Your Excellency. Before we stand up for the ziyara, I'd just like to point out my appreciation towards a few individuals who have been the backbone for this event. Bilal Muslim Mission Tanzania, the chairman, Al-Haj Riaz Bai Nasser, he has had amazing support towards us. He has given us everything that we have asked for. Thank you very much, Riaz Bai. Not forgetting the man who was with us from start to the end of the planning to making sure the banner was put up in the last minute, Brother Ain Sharif and his committee. Thank you very much for that. The media room from the KSI Jamaat, thank you very much. Before we stand up for the ziyara, I thank you all for coming here, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a witness that today we all gathered here, we all prayed together, and we all made sure that humanity came before any other religion. Gentlemen and ladies, can we please stand up and recite dua hujjah and ziyara.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad waliyan wa hafidhan wa qaidan wa nasiran wa dalilan wa aynan hatta tuskinahu arlaka tawan wa tumatti'ahu fiha طويلا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. السلام عليك يا رسول الله. السلام عليك يا حبيب الله. السلام عليك يا أمير المؤمنين يا علي بن أبي طالب. السلام عليك يا فاطمة الزهراء يا بضعة النبي يا قرة عين رسول الله. السلام عليك يا حسن المجتبى يا ابن رسول الله. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أنصار الحسين وعلى أخيك العباس وأختك زينب. السلام عليكم يا أهل بيت النبوة جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليك يا غريب الغرباء ويا معين الضعفاء والفقراء. السلام عليك يا أبا الحسن يا علي بن موسى الرضا. كن شفيعنا وشفيعا للوالدين في يوم الجزاء والحساب. السلام عليك يا فاطمة المعصومة. السلام عليك يا أختا ولي الله يا عمتا ولي الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليك يا حجة الله يا ابن الحسن يا صاحب العصر والزمان. السلام عليك يا إمامي وإمام الإنس والجان. عجل الله تعالى فرجك وسهل الله تعالى مخرجك وظهورك. رزقنا الله في الدنيا زيارتكم وفي الآخرة شفاعتكم. السلام عليكم يا أهل بيت النبوة جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. الفاتحة.
غلام مرتضی حسن ہے جس کا نام، بھاگتے ہیں مرتضی یقی ہے شیخ کا غم اساس انتقام کربلا کی دل میں ہے جو آس ہے بدن پہ کربلا کی خاک
اے سمندروں سے بڑھ کے اپنے چشمے نم